welcome and opening remarks of the symposium. You spoke to the group, and your discussion was basically on forced migration and forced displacement and migration in recent years. Why do you think the symposium is a good time to bring together experts from across Europe and the States?
Well, I think certainly this is one of the defining challenges of the current time. Now, I think already there we have to differentiate a little bit. When we look at the numbers actually currently in Europe, I think they will actually be quite manageable. But it has taken up a very strong political importance in the discourse that we have in many countries around Europe. So I think the topic at hand is of critical importance. And I think looking also specifically at the role of civil society can play both in shaping the narrative around what we're facing, but also at presenting solutions, presenting way forwards, addressing the challenges and opportunities of migration in our societies. I think it's critically important at the current time, so I'm very grateful that I could be part of this discussion at the symposium here at Oxford.
And we're obviously focusing a lot on the challenges around the relationship and the cooperation between, you know, two very different agents. What do you see? Is there any one commonality that there are in terms of opportunities for that relationship?
I think this is the critical question. How do we frame the opportunity? How do we frame, how do we understand, or what is the solution that we are aspiring to? I think the cooperation between governments and civil society organizations can be extremely fruitful when there is a common understanding, common vision of where we want to go as a society in addressing migration. And I think this is what we should aspire. Unfortunately, at the moment, I think there is a widening gap between what civil society organizations would want to see with regards to migration and what certain governments around Europe are putting on their agenda. And this creates all sorts of tensions that I think is not necessarily conducive, neither for the governments, certainly not for civil society organizations. I think if we approach civil society organizations, and I do represent the government here, if we approach civil society organization with an attitude of considering them a legitimate partner in a democratic dialogue around the challenges and opportunities of migration, a transparent, open, and frank debate, I think we can certainly move forward as societies together. But there has to be space for that dialogue to happen, and I think that space is actually shrinking at the moment.